Bonjour tout le monde et bienvenue à la Connexion Française. Hey everybody and welcome to French Connection. Aujourd'hui on fait des crêpes. Today I'll be showing you how to make crepes. So to make crepes, you're going to need two mixing bowls, two eggs, 1.5 cups of milk, 1 cup of flour, and also about 2 tablespoons of melted butter. Now, if you're going to be melting butter in the microwave, make sure you don't put it for more than 20 seconds at a time. Otherwise, the butter might explode and splatter in your microwave, and that's not very good. Additionally, since I like mine a little bit sweeter, and to make it more of a dessert crepe, I will be adding 2 tablespoons of sugar, and also 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. Let's begin, shall we? Allons-y! So first, we're gonna want to warm up some milk. Take your 1.5 cups of milk and set that on a medium high. But make sure you don't set it to high heat, otherwise you'll burn your milk. Now, normally, you wouldn't want to be working on the stovetop, but for the purpose of this video, I will be working on it so that everyone can see the process. Take your small mixing bowl and add your 1 cup of flour to it. Here, I'm using cake flour, but you can also use all-purpose flour or any other type of flour that you wish. Now, my flour came out quite clumpy. Normally, I would use a sifter to break up the clumps to ensure that it mixes properly. Now I'm going to add the 2 tablespoons of sugar. Et voila! Give this a simple mix and set aside. Next, take your large mixing bowl. Don't forget to check on your milk. Remember, we only want our milk to be warm, not boiling. While my milk is warming up, crack your 2 eggs. So now, you're gonna want to whisk your eggs. That looks about done. Don't forget, let's check on our milk. The milk seems to be slightly warm, but could be warmer, so let's wait a bit for it. So, I just tested my milk, and now it's sufficiently warm, so I'm gonna turn off the heat. We're going to be adding about 1/3 of the milk at a time, so let's add our 1/3 of the milk, and set the rest of your milk aside. Since we're mostly working in thirds, we'll also be adding 1/3 of our flour mixture at a time. While you're stirring with one hand, try to add about 1/3 of the mixture with your other hand. And start mixing, making sure that all the flour, even the stuff that gets caught on the sides, are well incorporated into your batter. Now, as you can tell, since I didn't sift my flour, you can start seeing clumps in my batter, which is not that great. To smooth out your batter, you can also run it through a sifter at the end to remove all the clumps. Now, once all my flour is incorporated, add your next third. You'll start to notice that as you add the flour, your batter will start to thicken. There, that looks about right. So now that our batter is done, you can add the rest of our milk. So again, as you're stirring with one hand, add the rest of the milk with the other. Now, be sure to be gentle, because as everything is mixing, you might splash yourself. And don't forget the sides! You know your batter will be ready once you can't feel any more batter at the bottom of your bowl. Once that's done, add 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. Give that a quick stir. And while you're still stirring, add your 2 tablespoons of melted butter. And there you have it, our batter! So, now you will need to refrigerate your batter for about 30 minutes to allow it to set. See you all in 30 minutes!
75 years later.
After your batter has set, take out a frying pan and set it to medium-high heat. Make sure the pan is relatively hot before you start. To scoop out batter from the mixing bowl, we're gonna need a ladle. First, you're going to want to add a little bit of butter to your frying pan so that it doesn't stick. Once you have that ready, scoop out 3/4 of a ladle and add it to your frying pan. After adding it, make sure you swirl your frying pan around so that the batter forms a circular shape and let it rest. You can let it sit for 2 minutes, or for me, I prefer to look at the edges. Once they start turning brown on the edges, or if you shake your frying pan and the crepe becomes loose, you'll know that that side is ready to flip. Now, I'm starting to notice that my edges are starting to brown, so I'm gonna give it a little shake. Once it's ready, it'll be really easy to move around in your frying pan. If it's stuck, you might want to give it a little bit more time, or check to make sure that it hasn't burned yet. Now, once you've flipped it, you'll only need about 1 minute on this side. Give it a quick shake, and look! It's already ready! Et voila! Our crepe is now complete. So now, I'm going to show you how you can decorate your crepe. You can use any type of filling you want. Normally, I really love ice cream crepes, so I usually will add ice cream in the middle. But today, I will show you a simple strawberry whipped cream crepe. If you're wondering why my crepe looks a little bit different here, it's because it's actually the second side of my crepe. The first side you saw earlier is on the bottom and will serve as our outside because it just looks nicer. So first, I'm going to take some of my whipped cream and add it right in the middle. You can add however much you want inside your crepe, but because I'm a total whipped cream fiend, I'm going to add quite a bit actually. That looks pretty good. Next, I'm going to add some sliced strawberries. You can add whatever fruits you want, like kiwis, or bananas, or even chocolate and Nutella. I think I'm gonna need more strawberries. There you go! Now, I'm gonna show you how to fold the crepe. Take the two ends and fold in slightly. Then, take the two sides and fully wrap it around. And there you have it! Your crepe is now ready for action. You can also drizzle chocolate over the top, but I'm gonna dust it with some icing sugar. Whoops, got a little too much in the middle. Because I love whipped cream, I'll just be adding a little dollop on the side. Whoops, let me fix that up. And one final slice of strawberry to complete the dish. Et voila, your crepe is finally ready to be eaten. Bon appétit, mes amis. Enjoy your crepe, and I'll see everybody next time. Au revoir. Bye.